Good afternoon, everyone. I want to take this opportunity to bring everyone up to date onto the events from yesterday afternoon. Before I begin, I want to make it known that the entire incident was captured on the officer's mobile video recorder, his in-car camera, and also on his individual body-worn camera. However, this morning I've been presented a subpoena by the Hamilton County prosecutor that will prohibit me from showing that video today. Pending his review, I am told that we will be allowed to release it probably early next week. So with that, I'm going to try to walk you through the events yesterday, showing a few photos from the scene. Yesterday afternoon, about 12:05 p.m., a undercover officer assigned to our gang unit was operating an unmarked vehicle in the area of Blair Avenue and Hartford Street. You can see here in the left-hand side of your screen. While patrolling in that area, he observed a male individual remove a handgun from his pocket and place it into his waistband. That individual has now been identified as Mr. Vernell Jackson, a male 20 years of age. The plainclothes officer broadcasted a description of Mr. Jackson to other officers in the area via his police radio. Officer Mark Schillmeyer, assigned to the gang unit, responded. Officer Schillmeyer was in a marked police vehicle and wearing the uniform of the day. On his way to the area, Officer Schillmeyer activated his in-car camera and his body-worn camera, as I had stated before. The undercover or plainclothes officer continued his visual surveillance of Mr. Jackson until Officer Schillmeyer approached the area. Officer Schillmeyer arrived and stopped his vehicle in front of Mr. Jackson on Blair Court at Blair Avenue, just in front of the basketball courts here where you see the cars. The vehicle on the left is Officer Schillmeyer's marked police vehicle. The vehicle on the right is a unmarked civilian car that the plainclothes officer was operating. Officer Schillmeyer exited his vehicle in front of Mr. Jackson. At that point, Mr. Jackson's left hand was behind his back. Officer Schillmeyer gave Mr. Jackson three separate commands to show his hands. Mr. Jackson removed his left hand from behind his back and displayed a firearm pointed at Officer Schillmeyer. Officer Schillmeyer ordered Mr. Jackson to put the gun down and discharge one round, striking Mr. Jackson in the right side of his torso. Mr. Jackson immediately fell to the ground, and Officer Schillmeyer immediately summoned for Cincinnati Fire to respond via his radio as the undercover or plainclothes officer approached and assisted, placing Mr. Jackson into custody. Officer Schillmeyer then immediately began applying pressure to the wound received by Mr. Jackson and began to administer life-saving techniques. One of the things I want to highlight here is that when you get the opportunity to see the body-worn camera, I think it is definitely worth noting the extreme efforts that Officer Schillmeyer took in trying to save Mr. Jackson's life. There was a tremendous amount of bleeding from the wound, and Officer Schillmeyer, his efforts were simply tremendous. Mr. Jackson was transported to the University Hospital Medical Center, where he is currently in critical but stable condition. There was a firearm recovered at the scene. It was a High Point 380 caliber semi-automatic pistol with 8 rounds in the magazine. Mr. Jackson is currently being charged with aggravated menacing and carrying a concealed weapon. This is Mr. Jackson, male, age 20. The officer involved, Officer Mark Schillmeyer, he joined the Cincinnati Police Department in 1996 and is currently assigned to our Special Services Section, our gang unit. At this point, I'm going to turn it over to the mayor, and then I will try to answer any questions that you may have.
Thank you, Chief, and thank you for your leadership of this department and the city. I want to also thank Officer Schillmeyer for his service to our community for over 20 years, and also the humanitarian efforts to save the man's life who pointed a gun at him. The fact of the matter is, as we all know, there are too many shootings and there are too many guns out in our neighborhoods. Our officers run to the danger. We ask them to do that, to try to make the community and the neighborhoods safer. And it is obviously very dangerous work, and we have seen far too many officers murdered here and across the country. If you point a gun at a cop, you will be shot. And we will continue, and we will not be deterred by the people in our community that want to shoot others and cause harm. Obviously, there'll be an investigation, and we'll wait for that. But having heard the description from the chief, I want to let the officer know that he has our full support. And we thank him for his humanitarian efforts to save the life of the suspect. Thank you very much.
This is a situation that the city of Cincinnati never wants to be in. You know, our police officers have a very difficult job, and thankfully they have the best training in the entire country. However, every time a police officer discharges their weapon, it's a very serious matter. And as the mayor mentioned and the chief mentioned, there's going to be an investigation going on by the police department and also by our independent Cincinnati Citizens Complaint Authority. We'll get to the bottom of this, and we'll make sure that we are as transparent as possible with all the information. We owe a lot of our efforts that we're doing to reduce crime in Avondale. Avondale, as you know, last year had a tremendous reduction in crime, you know, and we owe it to the neighbors and the community members in Avondale to continue that. And we'll continue, like the mayor said and the chief said, to continue to use all of our resources, use all the data to make sure that we keep our neighborhood safe so people can live in peace.
The investigation is still continuing. As I mentioned, it is currently under review of the prosecutor. There is a parallel independent investigation by the Cincinnati Citizen Complaint Authority and our internal investigation section. Again, still very early, continuing to follow up on other information, but I will try to answer questions that you have at this time.
Do you understand that Mr. Jackson had just gotten out of jail the night before? Can you comment on that? What his past criminal history is, or why he was?
I'm not sure if it was the day before, but what I understand is he has a very minor criminal record, misdemeanors. I don't believe there were any prior serious charges.
What was he suspected of doing when you guys were questioning? What was the reason you?
We had officers in the area, obviously, as you are very well aware of. We've had some recent shootings in the Avondale neighborhood. The plainclothes officer that noticed Mr. Jackson, he simply noticed that he transferred a gun from his pocket into his waistband. The keen observation of this officer saw that. He asked for additional officers to respond. That's why Officer Schillmeyer responded.
Was there any other verbal exchange other than what the officer, what you already said the officer said? I mean, did, when, the, did the person who got shot, did Jackson say anything?
When you get to see the body worn camera footage, you'll see that at least three times the officer told Mr. Jackson to show the officer his hands, and then additionally he directed him to put the firearm down before he discharged his weapon.
But Jackson didn't say anything verbally?
Not until, I believe, after the incident occurred.
Can you talk about what he said?
I mean, he was, I don't recall specifically, he was suffering from a gunshot wound and saying some different things.
Was he alone?
There was a young lady on the scene, and when you see the body-worn camera, she will be redacted because she's an innocent bystander. She was not involved in the incident.
Is Jackson suspected in any other shootings in the area?
Not that I'm aware of.
You had a gang unit out there, Chief. Is the recent rash of shootings related to gangs?
Well, we have a number of different units out there. Gang unit just happened to be one of the units that have been giving the area some attention.
The firearm, you got a system where you'd be able to check where that weapon
is? We have. What we know at this point, the firearm was legally purchased. However, we are not certain how it got into the possession of Mr. Jackson. So we are continuing to follow up on that as well.
Mr. Jackson does not have a CCW, I'm guessing?
Correct.
So do we know who is the owner of that?
We do.
Can you go into that at all?
From what I understand, it was legally purchased, but that is going to be part of the investigation. So I want to hold on to that for right now.
So there's been a dramatic decrease in crime in Avondale, certainly, you know, from 5 years ago to today. It's been relatively, steady as far as shootings at where it's gone down. Obviously, you had units in the area. You're making a great effort there. Yet still, there seems to be this perception, certainly among a certain segment of the population there, that it's an us against them, a certain distrust of police in that pocket, certainly. What can you do to change that perception, or do you agree that there's a perception?
Well, what I can say is you're right. We have seen some significant decreases. In the past 30 days, we have seen the challenges. However, I do disagree. We've gotten tremendous support from the community. I think that, and for the most part, that is a fallacy. We would not solve many of these crimes if community members didn't come forward and give us information. We always encourage and we always need more, because there are instances where we don't get enough information. But I think people support the police. I think people in every community support the police. I think people in Avondale support the police. I think that is a myth that people don't support the police.
I think the chief is 100% right. And one of the reasons that shootings have gone down so much in Avondale over the last 5 years is because of bravery like Officer Schillmeyer to go and confront people with illegal guns and to say, we're not going to take this anymore. And that's what the community is asking for our officers to do.
Absolutely. And I think people just want to see policing in a positive way. And we continue to work towards that. Without those partnerships, we would not have had the success that we've had.
One last question.
Prosecutors say why he wanted to look at this before he released this.
That is typically his practice, and he's a prosecutor. He has the authority to issue those subpoenas. I can't begin to speak for Mr. Dieters, but in this particular case, he's taking a little extra time before he allows us to release it. But again, it is captured on the body-worn camera and the MVR. I think it clearly shows the encounter. It clearly shows what occurred. And I believe early next week we will be able to release it. All right?
Thank you.
Thank you.